Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, we want to solve the following problem. Given triangle ABC, let D be the foot of the perpendicular from A to BC. Next, construct a semicircle with BC as its diameter and extend AD to meet the semicircle at P. Similarly, let E be the foot of the perpendicular from B to AC, and then construct a semicircle with AC as its diameter. Extend BE to meet this semicircle at Q. Next, connect C to P and connect C to Q. Given that CQ equals 10 units, our goal is to find the length of CP. And now for the solution. First, connect B to P. And then, consider triangle BPC and the semicircle. Observe that angle BPC is an angle in a semicircle. Recall that an angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Thus, angle BPC equals 90 degrees. Next, let angle PCB be theta. In right triangle BPC, we have cosine theta equals CP over BC. And in right triangle PCD, we have cosine theta equals CD over CP. Thus, CP over BC equals CD over CP, or after cross multiplying, CP squared equals BC times CD. Following this, connect A to Q and consider triangle ACQ and the semicircle. Similarly, angle CQA is an angle in the semicircle. Again, we use the property that an angle in the semicircle is a right angle to conclude that angle CQA equals 90 degrees. Next, let angle ACQ be phi. In right triangle ACQ, we have cosine phi equals CQ over AC. And in right triangle QEC, we have cosine phi equals CE over CQ. Thus, CQ over AC equals CE over CQ, or after cross multiplying, CQ squared equals AC times CE. Next, let's focus on triangle ACD and triangle BCE. Let's show that triangle BCE is similar to triangle ACD. Observe that angle CEB and CDA are both right angles. Furthermore, this angle is common to both triangles. That is, angle BCE equals angle ACD. Therefore, by the AAA similarity theorem, the two triangles are similar. Since corresponding sides of similar triangles are proportional, we have BC over AC, which the ratio of side BC to side AC, equals CE over CD, which the ratio of side CE to side CD. Or after cross multiplying, BC times CD equals AC times CE. Combining with earlier results, we thus have CP squared equals CQ squared, or after taking the square root, CP equals CQ. Given that CQ equals 10 units, therefore CP also equals 10 units, which is the solution to our problem. This marks the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more content. Thanks for watching and see you all next time.